That's all it is. War is a whole lot of men standing out in the field waving their pricks at one another. I look at war a little bit differently. To me, war is a lot of prick waving, okay? Simple thing, that's all it is. War is a whole lot of men standing out in the field waving their pricks at one another. Men are insecure about the size of their dicks, and so they have to kill one another over the idea. That's what all that asshole jock bullshit is all about. That's what all that adolescent, macho, male posturing and strutting in bars and locker rooms is all about. It's called dick fear. Men are terrified that their pricks are inadequate, and so they have to compete with one another to feel better about themselves. And since war is the ultimate competition, basically men are killing each other in order to improve their self-esteem. You don't have to be a historian or a political scientist to see the bigger dick foreign policy theory at work.
I'm a fucking idiot.
It sounds like this. What? They have bigger dicks?
Bomb them!
And of course the bombs
and the rockets and the bullets are all shaped like dicks. It's a subconscious need to project the penis into other people's affairs. It's called fucking with people! George Carlin's the fucking shit. Man, if there wasn't a bigger example of the big prick-waving dick fight that is going on right now in Iran. As it seems that Iran has backed off. I believe Trump will back off as well, because everybody has realized this is retarded. So it looks like we are going to see the end of this, I think. I don't think that you would continue this. Iran purposely missed, you know what I mean, actually hurting anybody, I believe. We don't know that 100% yet. But, you know, they were trying to throw down and they called each other's bluffs, basically, over there in Iran. So I think this will go no further, in my opinion. I was a little worried earlier. Because you don't want to get in, you don't want to get in any bullshit, you know, you just don't want to. So I think this is going to go nowhere anymore. And, yeah, I'll never be in favor, really much in favor of a war again after with, the U.S. lying to all the people of the country saying that Iraq was a threat and they had mass weapons and all these things. And then we didn't find shit. So they lied to us last time, so I'm not really in favor of wars. Now, Obama did a bunch of fucked up shit like this, but nobody ever really made a big deal out of it. Trump has done this, and it was like, World War III is happening, holy shit, you know? But Iran did threaten Abu Dhabi, did threaten Dubai, did threaten Israel, did threaten a lot of places. What the fuck is Awandi saying to me? Yeah, I told them to send you a bunch of crazy stuff on purpose. Yeah, so this is fucking hilarious. As you guys know, our friend Awandi is out in Dubai, and Iran threatened to blow up Dubai. Iran said, if you attack us back after our attack, which is like a fake attack, right? This is just them, like, we have to do something, we have to say something, so here's what we're doing. We're just blowing up shit that ain't gonna hurt you, really. But, like, don't do anything else, or we'll blow up fucking Dubai and Israel and shit. Like, they went crazy. And so I told Awandi, well, you know, here's, unfortunately, Awandi, he lost his mind, folks. Folks, listeners of the show, Awandi has lost his mind. This is no surprise. No, I'm just kidding. He didn't lose his mind. Listen to this. Oh, my God.
What the fuck is wrong with your country, you fucking faggots?
Fuck Trump!
Shut the fuck up! I'm trying to speak here. You go attack Dubai because you attack Iran? Huh?
Ariana?
Iran. You talk Iran because you want to go to war. They attacked you, your embassy. Now you're gonna attack. Now Iran is threatening. threatening. Now Iran threatening us embassy. They want to attack Dubai and Abu. Fuck you and your Trump and American. Fuck you, American. Oh,
my God, that was Awandi. But no, I'm just kidding. So I messaged Awandi. I'm actually friends with Awandi on Facebook, which is weird because I'm not friends with anybody on Facebook, and I don't accept friend requests usually. But because Awandi is so far away, he really can't get to me, so who cares? I mean, Awandi is in the Middle East. He's not going to get to me. So I told Awandi, I go, hey, Awandi, you should message Justin Bailey a bunch of crazy shit, like you're really angry, like you're blaming America for getting, you know, Iran so mad that they're threatening you guys. You know, because Awandi got, like, alerts on his phone, like, seek shelter and be aware and all this crazy shit. Everybody over in Dubai, Abu Dhabi got these alerts. So Awandi, obviously a listener of the show, I said, say all this shit to Bailey and then, like, say just crazy shit to him. And let's see if we can get Bailey to, like, really think you're serious. And I don't know if it worked or not. Well, Awandi would have to tell me. But so he sent me the I was like, send me the messages too, because I want to hear what you send to Bailey. Like, why the fuck did you get us into this, America? You fuck. Like, and he said a bunch of shit.
America, go to hell. I hope Jesus Christ dies in your cross again when he comes back. Allahu Akbar, you cuss him.
Oh, my God. I told him there's nothing scarier to Americans than, like, people from the Middle East yelling in Arabic. So, like, just say a bunch of crazy shit. And Awandi did it.
America, go to hell. I hope Jesus Christ dies in your cross again when he comes back. Allahu Akbar, you cuss him.
Oh, my God.
هذا بيخرب عليهم بيخرب عليهم بعدين شو بيسوون أولنا بيهجموا علينا إحنا نكسر مك okay
أتمسخر علينا. I just picture Bailey getting these messages and being like, what the fuck, oh my god dude, I'm fucking gonna die.
أمك وقص أم ترامب وقص أم أهلك الأمريكا. Fuck you America. You fuck you America's dick. My suck my dick.
Ball suck.
Justin Faggy Bailey, go sail away again, you faggot. Pray for our soldiers. Pray for God. Fuck you and your God. Jesus Christ, suck my pussy.
Oh my God, dude. Awandi is talking about Bailey put out a message on Twitter that was like, pray for the soldiers or something like that. Pray for the soldiers. And so that's what Awandi is talking about right there. JB said something like, I don't know. I got to go find it. Hold on a minute. Oh, wait. Here's his Twitter. This is like JB's fifth Twitter. JB wrote, God be with our troops. So this is, JB wrote, God be with our troops. I wrote something below that. I wrote, what did I wrote? I wrote, that's what their troops are saying too. God is, God this, God that. There's so many dead people in the name of an invisible man. But no, JB wrote, God be with our troops. And that's what Awandi is responding to here.
Pray for our soldiers. Pray for God. Fuck you and your God. Jesus Christ, suck my pussy.
But yeah, Awandi's kidding. Awandi was joking. I don't know if... Did he really block you? Awandi said he blocked him. Awandi told me that JB blocked him. But I think that's his... Honestly, Awandi, I think that that's his way of fucking with you back. I think he's fucking with you back by blocking you, thinking that he's mad at you. I think he knows, because I unfortunately, I already told him, like, oh, yeah, I told him to say all this crazy shit to you. like, and then in Arabic too and everything. So I think the jig is up on that. Or as they say in racist Oklahoma, the jigaboo's up. Okay, let's see what else we got here. Ladies and gentlemen, Kasim Soleimani. Salami. He's back, ladies and gentlemen, and he's back big. Here he is.
Hello, it is me from the dead. I am Soleimani. Those fucking American dumb fucks and their orange asshole murdered me. Fuck them. Joke's on yous, the guy who replaced me is even more of an Islamist extremist and is fucking you up now with dildo bombs. Dummies.
So their version of Pence took over. That's a good point, Kasim.
Pray for our soldiers. Pray for God. Fuck you and your God.
America, go to hell. I hope Jesus Christ dies in your cross again when he comes back. Allah Akbar, you kassum.
Oh, man. Thank you, Kasim. Salami. Oh, salami. Salami. He's back.
My name is Kane and I'm donating.
Yes.
I forgot to mention was a huge Cronin fan.
Oh, thank you.
He'll prove it. She okay. said her name was Sally Sandy. We stole the Mike's Hard Lemonade out of the refrigerator.
Wow.
Her dad wasn't home. And then you kissed me. So good. So right. Wanna be with you all night.
Oh my God. That is a reference to a song that I made 6 years ago? Holy shit, you really are a JCS fan. Where the fuck is that song? Wow.
What else we got? Oh, a little bit of the bubbly.
That's it. That's
Want
it.
Some bubbly? Look at this stuff. Oh, a little bit of the bubbly.
That's it. That's
now that I've bombed those sand coons and have wiped out their small dick leader, now we bomb those unusually brown-skinned Obama fags.
Oh.
Fuck Michelle and her retarded homosexuals they call children.
Oh my God, Donald Trump. What the hell?
I'm cleaning up my system there.
Donald Trump, man, unbelievable. What is going on, man? Why can't everybody just love each other, man? Why can't everybody just get along and love each other? Why can't everybody get along?
Oh, a little bit of the bubbly.
That's it. That's
Want
it.
Some bubbly? Look at this stuff. Oh, a little bit of the bubbly.
That's it.
Goddamn towel heads. Fuck you all. We will rape your women and pillage your land. Then install democracy in your third world countries.
No.
America bitches.
That's terrible.
Whoop, whoop, whoop.
God damn, Mike Amelto. God damn it. Mike, what the hell, Mike? Wait, we have Crystal on the phone, everybody. Crystal, hello.
Shout out to my boy Nickers. Nickers.
No, don't sing.
Oh, my God.
You piece of shit.
Oh, a little bit of the bubbly.
That's it. That's
Want
it.
Some bubbly? Look at this stuff. Oh, a little bit of the bubbly.
That's it.
Hey there.
Make a 1DN donation.
Yeah, that really should be a donation, huh? Put all of his things together. You know what I mean? Put all of Wandy's things together.
America, go to hell. I hope Jesus Christ dies in your cross again when he comes back. Allahu Akbar, you kassum.
So for the people just getting here, I told a Wandy. Even though Wandy likes Trump, I told Wandy to message Bailey saying he was angry about everything going on and just to flip out on Bailey and to say that he hates our God and say a bunch of stuff in Arabic that would scare JB. And Wandy did, but he also sent me the messages before he sent them to Bailey. And it's gold.
America, go to hell. I hope Jesus Christ dies in your cross again when he comes back. Allahu Akbar, you kassum.
Oh, man. Don Imus. Did you guys know that Don Imus is dead?
Don Imus is now dead. There's no more saying nappy heads. He's dead. Don Imus. Don Imus is now dead.
He's dead. Don Imus is dead. Ladies and gentlemen, on the phone is a special guest all the way from Zimbabwe, Tommy NC2010. Hello, Tommy.
Hello, Joe. How are you doing tonight?
Hakabahala. How you doing?
Not much. Just chilling. Just got done eating an apple.
Oh, a little apple poo there, huh?
Yeah, it was quite delicious.
Well, you know, I had my... Oh, a delicious apple. You know, I just had an apple too, Tommy.
An apple a day keeps the doctor away.
Yeah, a lot of cancer patients disagree, but, you know, that's what they say. But no, I did just have dinner. I'm just kidding. I didn't have an apple. I actually did not have an apple. I wish I did have an apple. But I did just have dinner, and it was good, and it tasted lovely. And I thought of you as I was eating, too.
Interesting. Okay. I had some ham and a chicken leg for dinner tonight.
I thought you said you had an apple.
Well, I had that as a snack.
Oh, my God.
What?
A ham and a chicken leg? That's not good for you. I thought you were supposed to be losing weight.
It's grilled chicken. It's grilled chicken leg.
I don't think that that's good either. I mean, I guess it's okay. I guess grilled chicken is all right. It's better than fried chicken, but... And what else? You had ham with it?
Well, it wasn't a big piece of ham. It was a small piece of ham.
All right. Can you say oink, oink, it's yummy time for me?
No.
Damn it. Why not? Why wouldn't you do that? Come on, man. I'll do it. Ready? Watch this, Tommy. Look at this. Oink, oink, yummy time. Now you do it. I did it. You do it.
Oh, God. Because it's going to get built into some kind of meme. I'm going to get thousands of tweets of people tweeting that.
If they do it, they'll do it to me too, because I just did it. You know what I mean? But you got to put a lot into it. You know, you got to get oink, 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 yummy time. Like that. I'm going to do that too. Let's see who can do the better one. You or me. Let's find out.
I do that because in tribute of Ultimate Warrior, I am Ultimate Warrior. Why I do that.
But I think you should do oink oink yummy time. I'll do it too. Ready? I'll do this. I'll do it. And we'll see if you can do it better. And then people will like put us together in the memes and gifs. Ready? Oink oink piggy time.
Oink oink piggy time.
Yeah, see, I think I put more effort into it. I think mine was a little more. Like, you gotta like really squeeze your face so you can see how fat you are, like I did.
Oh. Well, I'm starting to lose I'm starting to lose the chance, as you guys classically would.
But anybody will have it if they squeeze their face to their body like I just did. So if you just do that and you go, oink oink piggy time.
No, thanks, Joe.
I did it.
I know. I know. I just rather not say that. I mean, I said it already, you know.
Yeah, you kind of did, yeah.
But yeah. How have you been doing, Joe? You been doing okay?
I've been doing pretty good, man. I'm not unwell, thank you. How are you doing?
As long as you're... But how are you mentally?
Mentally? Pretty good, man. I'm in a great... good mindset, I think. You know, I want to find that song that guy just referenced because it's from so long ago. But other than that, yeah, I'm in a pretty good mind frame, man. It's gonna be it's probably the best I've felt in a long time, to be honest. I feel so good. I'm almost scared about it. You know what I mean? You know, when you let your guard down, like you're worried something bad's about to happen because like you just like this can't be. Things are going too okay right now.
Word of advice, Joe? The best thing is not to look for the bad things. The best thing is just to look in the positive and not think of the negative. If something negative happens, it happens. But the best thing to do is look towards the horizon as a young Luke Skywalker, and you hear, ooh, do, 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 do. How's that sound?
Horrible.
What? How is that horrible?
That was just horrible. I don't know. Like, what you just did was, in like I now hate everything. Like, a minute ago, I was happy. You asked me how I was feeling, and I was feeling really positive. And whatever you just did, I don't know if it was like a dog whistle or something, but you made me just want to kill people with what you
just
did.
That was a Star Wars theme song.
Yeah, but you were doing it. Like, if I heard the song, I'd be like, oh, that's beautiful. But, like, you were going, ooh. Like, so, like, everything inside of me is dead now because of what you just did. Like, I want to, I was in a good mood. I told you I've been in such a good mood this year. And the last couple, really the last 6 months have been so great. And this past couple days, I felt really good and everything. And what you just did made me want to, like, eliminate my enemies. Like, and then yell at my neighbor and, like, maybe break his dog's leg.
Really, Joe? That's really mean.
Yeah.
The fuck, man?
It is mean.
I never say that towards you.
What did I say towards you?
You said basically that I, you know, basically made you angry because I was doing the Star Wars theme song.
Yeah, that noise that came out of you made me, like, it's not you that made me, like, you didn't really make, there's nothing you're, like, it's not directly you, but something about that frequency that you just hit, like, I don't know what it is, like, my whole mindset has changed. I started this podcast, and, like, you asked me how I felt, and like I said, I felt pretty good, but now, like, I kind of want people to blow up. And I mean, like, it's weird. Like, I can't explain it. Like, I'm thinking about, like, I don't know what it is. I'm going to jack off to a picture of Crystal.
Oh, fuck you, Joe.
Nah, but what else is going on, Tommy? How's everything else been going, you know?
Not much. Just been getting up at 5 a.m. in the morning and going to work at the gym.
Have you run into any weird situations at the gym now that you're working out there so much? Like, you know what I mean? The weights or somebody yelling at somebody or people getting kicked out or...
No, I kind of mind... Everybody kind of minds their own business to each other. You know, everybody works out, does what they want to do. And, you know, you know, I've never had any trouble with anybody at the gym. I kind of have to go into a separate room now to do core.
Mm.
Now, because it is really hard for me to do core. It is really difficult. I've been trying to push myself to make myself last longer in core.
Yeah. What? Yeah. Added some in my throat. Yeah, core is, that's always tough.
Flutter kicks, yeah. Oh my gosh. I call them fuck kicks. I hate them so much.
Well, it looked like you were getting fucking sucked off when you were doing them. So that's just funny that you call it fuck kicks.
Because I absolutely loathe them. You have to hold your legs.
Uh-huh.
You have to hold your legs like this, just up in the air, and move it back and forth.
Ugh.
You know? It is...
fucking hard.
Now, I don't know if any of your viewers are like health or stuff like that are exercise daily and then do that, but if they do, they probably know what I'm going through.
Yeah, you're getting sucked off is what's going on.
No, I wasn't getting sucked off. It is fucking hard.
Oh.
Guys, another day in the books.
Shout out to the girdle.
Oh, is what is derailed underneath your desk right now?
No, but I think he's in this video with you.
Shout out to the girdles.
No, Drew is too busy yelling at all the Iranian listeners of his show.
Shout out to the girdles.
you shot that one video. Where he popped up underneath your desk because he was trying to blow you.
That was the beginning of Monetize This.
Oh yeah, it was an episode of Monetize This when he visited you.
Oh, look at this. Oh. You know what I gotta do is I gotta get this shot with you like doing that, and then like Drew coming up saying yummy. That's what I gotta get. I gotta get him saying yummy. Yummy. That's what he says, Tommy. After he blows me, he comes from under the desk. He goes, yummy.
That was me just taking my tongue and picking my tooth, like picking at my teeth.
That's, what are you talking about?
Sometimes I get apple pieces stuck in my teeth and I have to.
When were you picking your teeth? I didn't see it.
I was just, when I had my mouth like this, like that, that's what I was doing. Picking particles out of my teeth, my tongue.
Let's see if we can edit this together really well. Let's see if we can get just.
God.
We got Drew coming up here. I got to get the audio, too. I got to get, let me see if I can get the audio, Tommy. Let's see. You won't be able to hear it, unfortunately, but let me see if I can get it for everybody else.
Oh, I'm ready to go.
Oh, here it comes.
I'm ready to go. Oh. Yummy. Oh, no.
Yummy.
Oh, great. Another donation. What's that going to be, like $50, Joe?
No, that was, if anything, it's going to be Drew. It's going to be Drew saying yummy and him looking at the camera like a creepo. Like he was right there. I mean, tell me that's not the most disgusting, disturbing thing you've ever seen. Look at this.
Oh,
I'm
going to
pause it on his face.
I'm ready to go. I'm ready to go.
Watch this. Ready?
Oh. Yeah.
That's right there. That is the most disturbing thing I've ever seen. Hold on. Let me just. Like, right there. That is the. Oh, my God. That is so terrifying right there. That is the look of a psycho sex. Like a guy with a sex problem. Like, but with guys.
Joe, did you ever think in your lifetime that a fan/friend would actually want to do that to you?
Yes. I actually think I envisioned it, to be honest. Let me see if I can get it for everybody else.
Really? Fan/fan?
Yeah, blowing? It's weird. It is.
Oh, great. Another donation.
Let me see if I can. Yummy. Yummy.
Oh, no. Yummy.
Oh, my God. It's so disturbing, Tommy. It's the part where he says yummy that's scary.
Yummy.
Oh, my God. My good God. But, Tommy, at least I can make fun of myself. You know what I mean? Like, I make fun of me, too. I'll make fun of anything I do.
Yummy.
You know, I occasionally make fun of myself, you know, on occasion sometimes. Oh,
yeah. Sometimes. It's good to have a good laugh at yourself.
I'll call myself an idiot sometimes. Yummy. You know, like, because I'm... I forgot something or, you know, I did something wrong.
Yeah.
Damn it, you idiot.
Set a forest ablaze.
I did not do that, Joe. I don't know what you're talking about.
Okay. Remember those guys when they got mad at you, when you got mad at them for that, though? Do you remember that? Because I hate to bring this up, and I'll move on really quickly, but I do want to mention real quick. That fucking Reddit video gets brought up all the time by random people. Like, that thing is still fucking pumping on Reddit. Did you know that?
I don't know why. I really don't know why that video comes up every single time.
Yeah, it's all over the place. And what happens is, like, somebody who's new to listening to me or to you or whatever, like, for some reason, they find it, and then they send it to me like I've never seen it. And they're like, oh, have you seen this? Or, you know what I mean? It's weird. And I'm like, yeah, it's an old meme. It's pretty old at this point, you know? But it always comes up. It's so weird. But yeah, it's like it won't go away. It's like still always popular on Reddit or whatever. It's funny though when you flip out because it's not funny, but like, because like these guys invited you. What I don't understand is like they invited you over their house, what, so they could just fuck with you or something? Is that what was going on? Because it seemed like they were just fucking with you.
The other guys were fine. They were chill, but it was the other guy, I think it had another goal of fucking with me. And that's Drew. Drew, I mean, I'm still friends with Drew. I still talk with him. We're not team members anymore. We don't work like that as professionals anymore.
Sex team.
Huh?
You guys run a sex team together? That's Drew. Yeah, he reached out to me and told me about the the fornication thing that he was trying to get you in on in Boston or whatever.
No, I wasn't on a sex team with them. They were part of my YouTube team. Like, they were helping me with the titles and stuff like that, and...
Well, he told me that you kind of left the group because you sort of didn't want to be involved in the, like, the gay stuff anymore.
No, he accused me of being a pedophile, and that pissed me off, and I just stopped working with him because he made a statement that I would like to be a mall Santa Claus. I would like kids to sit on my lap.
Why was he accusing you of being a pedophile?
I don't know. He just brought it up. Like, but I know, like, he didn't say the word pedophile, but I kind of connected the dots when he said, I would like to be a mall Santa Claus and have kids sit on my lap. And I'm like,
do you think maybe he was, he must obviously was kidding though, right? I mean, it was just a joke. Like, I'd say that to Bailey.
Well, I took it really personal and I got really ticked off and I stopped talking to him for a while.
Is it because there's some truth to it?
No, there's no truth to that. Okay. I'm not a pedophile.
Yeah, because, I mean, that just sounds like a joke among friends. Like, oh, why don't you go be a mall Santa and let a kid sit on you? I'd be like, yeah, why don't you go get hit by a car, asshole? Like, I don't know. But, like, maybe
if you look at a lot of the episodes of the old episodes of Tommy Talks, it's basically, you know, like me correcting Drew and telling him to stop saying that. Or, you know, like,
I'm fucking with you a little bit here, but I think he's trolling you to get you angry. I think that that's what it is. I think a lot of people do that. I mean, you know, I think a lot of people troll you to get you angry. I've done it. A lot of people have. But the bottom line is, I guess
what's funny.
I was surprised by the fact that it is funny. It's funny when, you know, I don't think it's funny, though, when it really affects you. I think it's funny if you know it's a joke and you get mad kind of jokingly or whatever. And, yeah, sometimes when you flip out, obviously that's hilarious. But there's the other side of that that's like, oh, man, he's really angry. Like, you shouldn't really be angry. You know what I mean? But those guys definitely were trolling you, like, way back before anybody else was even trolling you. Because I remember watching that stuff back in 2013 and being like, what are they doing?
They were the ones that actually, those guys were actually the ones that gave me the idea for Tommy Talks. Like, you know, if it wasn't for them, I would have never been doing Tommy Talks today. Like, getting some of the good interviews that I've gotten in my past, you know, they were the ones that created the brainchild for Tommy Talks.
So maybe,
you know?
Maybe they're bitter to that. Like, you know what I mean? It seems like a lot of people help you, and sometimes Tommy, like maybe you don't understand, like, or whatever, like, and people feel slighted by you or something like that. You know what
I
mean?
I'm not trying to slight anybody. It's just sometimes I feel like people cross me.
Yeah.
Stab me in the back. Oops, sorry about that, Joe. Didn't mean to blind you like that.
No, it's me. I got the res. I had the res on high. There, I'll fix it for you. There we go.
Looks like an atomic bomb explosion. I have a big old studio light in my living room here. So, like, it just turns poof. Sometimes I can't look directly at it or I'm going to white out my eyes. You know what I'm saying? Have you ever done that? Have you looked straight into a light and just like, oh, you couldn't see for a second? You just see those black dots in your eyes?
Oh, yeah. I've seen the spots everywhere. But I mean, more than that, dude, like, it's like that's happened more to me when I'm like, you know, like a professional wedding photographer, you know, back in the 90s or 80s and they flash that big flash bulb and you can't see shit for like an hour.
Don't you just hate it in your prom, like not prom pictures, but I'm trying to think high school, like the high school pictures, like yearbook. Everybody's like, why are you closing your eyes in your yearbook picture? Because they have a big light in my eye and they flash it. And you're like, oh, try not to be blinded by this massive light, you know, but some kids can actually keep their eyes open. But, you know, some pictures, you know, they have their eyes closed because it's just this bright light flashing in your eyes.
You know what I miss is the old VHS cameras. When you would tilt them around in the lights in the dark, and the lights would streak across the screen and make that cool like effect, you'd get that drag because the anamorphic style camera was different back then. You know, I don't know. I kind of miss that. I mean, it was annoying and that sucked. You know, when you film something at night, but I mean, I kind of miss it in a way. It's like a sort of a nostalgia seeing those streaks of lights in the dark when you're filming with an old camera.
And now you just have as a filter on, yeah. on either Facebook or Instagram. You know, I gotta say something. I mean, everything that like from the 90s to the 80s, you know, it's still res. But when you ask somebody like modern today, hey, do you know what a VCR is? And they're like, what's a VCR? And I'm like, are you kidding me? You don't know what a VCR is? Like, no, what's a VCR? Do you know what a VCR tape is? No. Do you know what Blockbuster is? No. What's Blockbuster?
Who the hell doesn't know what Blockbuster is? Even young people know about it, right? Because we won't shut the fuck up about it.
Well, Netflix was the reason why Blockbuster went out of business. That was the real reason that Blockbuster went out of business.
Yeah, I mean that's a big reason. Blockbuster, a lot of people forget how Blockbuster put a bunch of Family Videos out of business, though. You know, your local mom and pop video stores were everywhere, and Blockbuster put a shitload of them out of business, and they themselves got put out of business by an even bigger company. Hey, I'm going to play a donation real quickly because I got a few backed up here, see what they say, and then I'm going to ask you about this Iran shit. Hold on a second. Super Let's see
jet.
What we got.
Super jet.
Passenger plane in Iran just crashed.
Oh, yeah. Jesus Christ. I just saw that. A passenger plane with 180 people just crashed in over Ukraine.
Oh, my gosh.
So who the hell
We've
knows
got
what
a
that's
new
about?
Twitch follower. Hell
Autistic
yeah.
Trump.
Take my pants off.
Thanks for following me on Twitch. All right. Looks like we're going to have to turn the Twitch alerts off as far as Twitch goes. Yeah, man. That's wild. That's fucked up. So there's a plane, dude. 180 people went down. So that's pretty
Shit
crazy.
Bomb.
Slop 75.
Oh God.
Slop 75.
Oh God.
Slop 75. Slop 75.
Oh no.
Slop 75. Slop 75. Slop 75. Slop 75. Oink oink. It's yummy time. Slop 75. Slop 75. Slop 75. Slop 75. Slop 75. Slop 75. Oink oink.
Oink
it's
oink.
Yummy time.
Oink
How
oink
much
it's
money
yummy
for
time.
Tommy to bob for apples on the stream?
Hey Tommy, Super this guy wants Super to know. Well, I'll tell you 1 second.
Tommy, a chicken leg is not healthy. Eat white meat.
Corin Eberle says, Tommy, a chicken leg is not healthy. Eat white meat. That's what Corbin Eberle says, and I think he's right. I really think a chicken leg is not good. But Sally Sandy said slob 75 a million times and then did ask how much for you to bob for apples on the stream.
I don't know.
I mean, obviously it's a little it's a little fucked up, you know, but you know, somebody wants you to bob for apples. But I don't know how much would it cost? How much would it cost for somebody for you to bob for apples on a video? That's a weird request, I feel like.
Okay. Since it's kind of embarrassing and indignifying, in my opinion.
Yeah.
I would say around $400.
Of course, you'd have to go get the apples in the barrel and like bob for your. You'd have to go do all this shit. To make fun of yourself, basically. How much?
$400.
Whoa! Wow, I don't think that's going to happen. That's a lot of money.
I know.
It's a lot of money.
That's
$400.
Why, you know, I mean, then you say, Tommy, then, you know, why would you get a pie thrown in your face for free? I can... And I did that for comedy's sake. I just did it for, because in this world that people are depressed and sad, I just did it for comedy's sake. And
it was weird. It was very strange. But yeah, I mean, but if you did that, you'd have to donate it directly to Tommy because unless you're going to give me something out of it, folks out there, you have to do $600 or $500 because I'm not paying the taxes for Tommy to bob for apples. But it would be quite interesting to see. I guess I'd go 400 if you were in a pig suit. Like if you were in a pig suit and you had to like oink every few minutes while you were doing it, I might think 400 for that. For just regular you bobbing for apples, I'd say $100. But bobbing for apples in a pig suit with a little piglet tail and oinking here or there, and also crystals in the background cheering you on, that I would pay some money for. That would be funny, but it would be indignifying in a way, so it would be quite humiliating. See, I would do it. That's the thing is, like, there's no double standard here. I would do that. So
you would do that? You would, like, the great Joe Cronin, the great radio host.
Yes.
Host of Monetize This, host of Corrupted Podcast, host of any show, that convoluted show that you create from the mind, you would indignify yourself like that.
What the hell is convoluted about my show?
No. I'm just saying any, I didn't mean to say it negative. I said whatever show that just comes to your head and you create.
Okay. Yeah. I mean, whatever. I mean, yeah, I would do it. I do it for $200. I bob for apples for $200. I go get the apples. I get the barrel, stick that fucking thing on the ground live. I'd live stream it, and I'd play some kind of fucked up music in the background, and I'd paint my, I'd like act like a, like a, like a, like a fucking animal. And I go, and I have a small mouth, so it's going to be hard for me to bob for apples. I want to keep that in mind. I have a tiny mouth. I don't even know if I've ever been able to grab an apple out of a bucket, you know, to be honest. And you know what would be really funny, too, is if maybe we'll just do it in general. I'll bob for apples, and like every time someone donates $20, I have to try to bob for apples again, and I can't stop until I pull one out. And then the next donation goes off. Yeah, we could have Cronin bobs for apples. I'd do it.
You just sound like cringe there, but you just sound like cringe.
If I was cringe, I'd beat up a homeless person and then shit in their mouths.
I'm actually not talking to him right now.
Well, neither is God, so. the God of death, the God of cringe. Yeah, I mean, he is a little funny. He is a funny little Jew, isn't he? But no, how's he? Why aren't you talking to him? How long has it been since you spoken with the God of cringe?
I don't know how long it's been. He tried messaging me the other day. I really didn't want to speak to him because there's been multiple occasions that I feel like he embarrassed me on a level that aggravated me, and I just don't want to speak to him for a while. And there was other things that I don't want to say here on air that he did that really kind of got underneath my skin. And damn. I'm still kind of aggravated at him because he did that.
Damn. That's fucking weird. Why does everybody... I mean, I will say I don't know. You know, it's... I know that sometimes... I don't know. I feel... I don't know, man. I don't know what to say. I feel bad for you sometimes in a way because of this.
And here's the thing. I give people a level of trust. Here is the level of trust I give people, and then people always just end up going like this, breaking that trust. And it's like a firm bond.
Unfortunately, people feel that they can kind of manipulate you a little bit. Like, you know what I mean? And everybody gets away with some things with you. You're funny, and a lot of people like to laugh, and a lot of people like to see funny shit. And so they kind of like, I don't know, everybody does it to you, and everybody does it because when you get, especially when you get alphas, right, a lot of alpha males, people who are, like, really about themselves and really want, you know, and it's not that they mean, I don't even think that some people mean to do it to you 100%, but you, like I said, you give people a rope, kind of, and I think a lot of times people take all of it, and they wouldn't take all of it with other people, you know, like, normally they wouldn't take advantage of it.
Just like with Sam Rasmus, he came into my life and started being my friend and started being really nice to me. And then all of a sudden I found out he's like the troll kingpin. Like he's the one the top running the whole entire show. And what made me learn that was over a period of time was when he leaked my Google Plus link. And I was interviewing this guy that wasn't just an extra, but he was if you remember the first Jurassic World movie, do you remember there was a scene where the guy was asking about, he's like, you know, how do you get these animals to mate? Do you just get like all these animals together and they just go at each other or something like that? There is a scene in Jurassic World where the guy is literally asking the scientists if they basically get these different species of dinosaurs to get together and sleep with each other. Like that's basically the whole joke that he said in the movie Jurassic World. And so, they're like, then he corrects him. He's like, no, we clone them and we put their genetics together. Like, you know, that's the whole thing that he says in the movie.
So there's some crazy shit going down tonight. Ukrainian Airlines Boeing 737 carrying 180 passengers has crashed in Iran. And on top of that, breaking news, 19 minutes ago, two strong earthquakes have struck Iran in the past 2 hours. The first, a magnitude 5.5, and the second, a 4.9. So double earthquakes have happened in Iran. A plane has crashed in Iran. And all the missile attacks by Iran on U.S. bases that apparently didn't kill anybody because Iran, you know, doesn't want to kill anybody. They just wanted to send some kind of retaliation. So what the fuck is going on in Iran right now? A plane goes down and then earthquakes. I mean, EMP, what is going on? What the fuck is going on right now? This is weird.
What if it's the end? What if this is slowly the end for us? This is the end of the world. We just don't know it. That no one even knows it, you know?
Well, it's funny you mentioned that, Tommy, because, you know, I got a song for that.
Oh, I thought it was it.
It's the end of the world as we know it. It's the end of the world as we know it. It's the end of the world as we know it. And I feel fine.
Suck my cock, suck my cock, suck my cock. Fucking something, 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 something. Blow it up. But no, it's the end of the world. No, it's the end of Iran. I mean, what is going on over? It's all in Iran. A 180 Boeing disappears from radar in Iran and crashes down. What is happening right now?
Is there any news about the passengers or anything like that? Are they
dead? They're dead.
Yikes.
I mean, this is crazy, dude. This is fucking crazy. What the fuck is going on? So earlier, Iran basically said there will be no more attacks. If this is where it ends, this is where it ends. They clearly didn't want to have some kind of real war. You know, our embassy got attacked. We killed their top general. They fired on our military bases. They apparently didn't kill any Americans, which was on purpose, I believe, because they could have shot things if they wanted to. So, and now Trump is kind of saying, like, everything's good. So hopefully Trump backs off, right? Because I don't want to go to war. I don't want to see a war happen. So, okay, hopefully Trump does what you wouldn't think Trump would do, which is back off, because you would think Trump would attack again. But hopefully Trump will back off and everybody will calm down. So it seems like that's what's happened. It seems like Trump is like, all right, I see your message. We'll stop too. It seems like that's what everybody's doing. Now, after that's happened, a fucking plane goes down carrying 180 people in Iran. And then on top of that, now double earthquakes in Iran. That is weird. I can't imagine that that's not coincidental. Like, it almost makes me think that somebody was trying to do something to trigger a fight or trigger something. Do you know what I mean? Like launch an EMP or launch a rocket, like or ballistics from somewhere else, and they fucked it up somehow, right? Like, imagine like some shitty group of people, and they're like, let's launch a missile and kill the U.S., like hit the U.S. because then they'll blame Iran, and maybe then the U.S. will do something. Do you know what I mean? It's the perfect time for that if you're a terrorist organization or you're some third party. Make America think that Iran did it, and now they're fighting. And what if they botched it and a missile blew up? Or what if they hit the fucking plane? You know, I don't know. Like, this is just weird. I haven't seen any news about this, so I have no idea what I'm talking about right now either.
It's hard to say what's happening, you know. You know, hard to say who's doing what and what is going on. You know, it's really hard to say.
Yeah, it's really weird. It's really weird. You know, Drew had a guy from an Iranian in his chat earlier today, and Drew lost his mind on this Iranian guy, and I thought, like, you know, I wouldn't have gone so off on the guy, because the guy said, you know, we're going to defend ourselves in Iran. You know, we had to, it was a defensive thing. We had to defend ourselves a little bit, you know, type of thing. And Drew was like, fuck you, and he lost his mind on the guy. I got to pull up that clip because it's so fucking funny to me. Hopefully it's up because Drew is hilarious, and I want to get a video of that. So hopefully that's still up on the air for us to look at. But I don't know if it is still up, so I'm going to try to find it. But I'm looking through it now, and I don't see it. Drew, did your show end on time?
He goes live every Tuesday night with podcasts.
He's plugging me here. But yeah, now I'm going to plug him because I thought this was so funny because the Iranian guy was all nice, and then Drew was like, fuck you! We'll... And I'm like, that's great. Now he thinks Americans are crazy. He's like, here's an American talking about it. It's like, nobody wants to fucking hurt these. Nobody wants the civilians hurt in Iran. I can't believe anybody really wants anybody hurt. Nobody wants...
That general, he was a terrorist general. Like, he was a bad guy. Like, you know...
Yeah, well, yeah. It's true.
He was part of, you know, like, he was a part of some bad things. And, like, of course, here's the thing I find interesting, that when Obama killed bin Laden, no one said anything. Everybody cheered. Hip, hip, hooray.
Well,
but the second Trump kills a bad guy, you know, while he's in presidency, all the liberals are actually getting down and apologizing for the death now.
Well, here's the thing. You can't compare these two because you had the wrong comparison. What you should have compared it with was when Obama performed drone strikes. Obama performed drone strikes on military targets and military personnel. That was never talked about. Nobody cared. You know, so yeah, Trump does it and he gets yelled at. But the bin Laden thing with Obama, that I wouldn't compare that because the people see Osama bin Laden as, you know, he blew up the towers. So, like, people can get behind that. So, yeah, I don't think they're comparable because that guy was a clear, like, enemy. Like, this guy, people in America don't understand what he's done. But, yeah, apparently he was meeting in Iraq with the, like, some of the, you know, like, militias, like, sort of like the ISIS groups or the militias. So he got blown up in Iraq. He didn't get killed in Iran. We didn't go to Iran and kill this general. We killed him, like, in a hideout place where he was meeting with, you know, these militias who attack us. And we're like, why is this guy meeting with militias who attack us? You know, and it's because he was helping them, apparently, allegedly. I don't know any of this to be true about anything, but that's what they say. So I can understand why they would do that. So, and they did that after our embassies were attacked, because our embassies were attacked by militias and by people who are, you know, known to be around this guy, apparently. So this guy's helping them. So, you know, they said, all right, kill that guy. And then, you know, Iran strikes us then at our military bases. But they don't really strike us because they didn't really want to kill Americans.
You know, if you think about it, you think it'd be better for us just to pull ourselves out of that country?
Oh, yeah.
And just let them kill each other? Like, do you think that would be better? Like, because it just seems like, you know, like, it's not going to get any better over there. It seems like there you are, you know, we just better, like, just back off and just, like, let them blow each other up. But the problem with that is then they start looking at us and then they come over here and then another 9/11 could happen, you know?
Well, you're going to get into a whole nother thing where I think that we allowed that to happen, but that's another story. Me and a lot of people have been over that quite a bit, but yeah, no, I mean, I don't want to be there. I'd say get the hell out of that place and just go home. Just come back home. Let whatever they've been fighting over there for like forever. It's like, just forget it. Like religion, when you get people believing in religion and stuff like that, and they believe it's real and that land matters to God or something like that. I mean, you can look back at the old fucking crusades and back in the old fucking wars way back in the day, all the blood and deaths over the name of the king and the fucking what God said and all this stuff. I mean, that's what's going on still over there, over land and holy land and holy shit.
Well, look at our country. We have a lot. There's a lot of spilled blood in our country. You know, like we, you know, over the South and the North and the, you know, just the different wars, the Redcoats and stuff like that.
But we don't do that now. You know, but see, that's different, though. We stopped that pretty much. That's way back. You know, this is still going on every day. Like, I mean, now our war, now we just fight like over socially. You know what I mean? Like, we fight over laws and shit like that, but we don't fight. We just talk about it. There's no, like, the states aren't fighting each other, and we're not having wars in our country. You know what I mean? Like, they're having wars, and all the little countries are fighting, and all these different things are being fought over. We're not really doing that here at all.
Can you imagine what it would look like if the United States actually went into a modern civil war? Like, what they had back in the day? There would actually be more carnage because of all the weapons, the automatic, semi-automatic weapons that we have now. Because back then they had just ball and muskets and stuff like that they fired. And, like, it would just be absolute so much carnage if there was a modern civil war today.
Oh, yeah, it'd be crazy. And the right-wing side of things would probably do a lot better. Because the not a lot of the left side are carrying around a lot of weapons or even know how to fire a weapon. So, you know, they have the upper hand when it comes to, it's stereotypical, but it's stereotypically like, you know, they have the upper hand when it comes to computers and social media, when it comes to where the money is controlled in some of the banks. But the right has a lot of the upper hand as far as the survival skills and the weaponry and the physical ability to defend yourself. It's kind of interesting to see that, how that plays out, but that's what makes us all different.
Joe, you just gave me an idea for something, for a sitcom or like a show that you would see on television. You know how they wife swap, they take people and they would switch it off. Well, what you do is you take a liberal and you take a Republican and you put them in the different houses and you see how that works, and call it a liberal Republican swap.
How about you put one in a room? You put the Republican in a room with a computer, and he has to hack the computer to get out, or the room squishes him to death. And then you put a liberal guy, like in the fucking forest, with some arrows and a fucking gun, and he's gonna defend himself against like highly trained fucking, I don't know, whatever the fuck. I don't know. It'd be kind of funny. But anyway, let me play a donation. There's a couple donations coming in.
Super chat.
See
Super
what chat. We got.
A salad a day keeps the fat fuck faggot away. Oh. Raised eyebrow.
Oh, my God. Yeah, Tommy is having salads every day, I believe. I think he's...
Yes, I have. I've been eating salads.
And apples, what Tommy's.
Oh, yes. A little bit of the bubbly.
That's it.
Comes Iran.
Some bubbly? Look at this stuff. Oh, a little bit of the bubbly.
That's it.
Tommy, we coming for you. You better run, fat boy. Fuck you, faggot.
Oh, my God. Tommy, I don't know why, but Iran just said that they're coming for you. Like, Iran said they're coming to get you. I mean, I don't know who that really is, but they say they're coming to get you. You're kind of starting to look like Bill Belichick a little bit.
Who's Bill Belichick?
He's the... Never mind. Never mind.
Do a little basketball dance off the concrete. I mean, I'm just so sick of you little meth head. Devil worshippers.
Oh, my God. A little bit of the yummy.
I'll be honest. I'd like to take a big bite out of your face.
A little bit of the yummy.
A little bit of the
yummy.
A little bit of the yummy. Isaac Brewer. What's up, Isaac Brewer? Thank you for supporting Throwdown on Tuesday nights. Here it is again. A little bit of the
yummy.
That is so nasty, especially the part after he says yummy where it goes...
Yummy.
Oh, Christ, that's disgusting. Drew is a sick person. He really is. He's a sick bastard.
Yummy.
Yummy. I'm still trying to find where he yelled at that guy. Drew, oh, here it is. I said, why do you hate Iranians, Drew, you racist? Here it is. Let me play this clip. This is great. Oh, Tommy, do you want to go on Discord at all?
Oh, a little bit of the bubbly.
That's it. I'm actually getting ready to jump off here, Joe.
Oh,
actually.
Oh, a little bit of the bubbly.
That's it.
Tommy's nickname should be the master of stating the obvious. Joe, when is the monetize this title on the line? I want the gold sucker.
Want the gold sucker? Yo, Will Tactics, thanks for the $3. Probably towards the end of January, probably at the very end of January, the monetize this championship returns and goes up, baby. Let me see.
Who is monetized's champion?
Nobody. It's been vacated at this point. So we,
is it back with you now, or like is it like still mid transfer?
I haven't told S dot Dollar to send it yet. I told him to wait until I get my PO box, and I think I'm getting my PO box. I think this week, hopefully. So I'm gonna pay for the PO box.
And you like your other PO box is all the way in Boston, am I right?
Right. And the other thing about that is they wouldn't let me get a PO box because my address change didn't go through, so I couldn't get the PO box. So I've just been delaying and delaying until I had to finally go get the license changed, and then I had to get the license in the mail so I could go down there and give that to them so they could see it. But then I also had to pay the $90 or whatever it is to open up the box. So bunch of shit. Yeah, it's fucking crazy. Have you ever gotten weird shit sent to you in your box, Tommy? Like a dildo or something like that?
One time I got a glitter bomb, but I didn't show it on camera.
A glitter bomb. That's hilarious. See, I'd freak out because I'd think like somebody sent me anthrax or something. So like it wouldn't be like a funny reaction at first. I mean, it would be funny actually. It'd probably be really funny. Cause I'd
anything. Here's the thing. Anything perverted or disgusting or anything like that, I would never show on camera. Like I.
So your reactions aren't genuine. You've actually seen what's already in the boxes.
I mean, my reactions are genuine, but if I have a suspicion about something and it looks really funny, like if the item looks really funny, because there's been at times like I really was being careful with what kind of stuff I was doing for Mailbox Monday, which I still wait for. Like we haven't had a Mailbox Monday in a while, but you know, I still have the PO box open.
I was going to send you stuff. I always wanted to send you a bunch of shit, but once I found out that you like pre-open stuff, then I went, never mind. Fuck that. You know, because I was like, it won't be funny. You know what I mean? Because you'll open it already and you'll already see it. You know, but if you opened it like straight up, like you were like, all right, here we go, and you're opening it for the first time, I would definitely have sent you all kinds of weird shit.
Well, if it was perverted, I would definitely just open the box and be like, nope. Okay, not showing that on camera. Not getting my video demonetized. Something like that, you know. Like if I was to see, like, if it was like if you bought me like a box of dildos, and it said my name on all of them, I'd just be like, nope, not showing that on camera.
Well, you can show dildos on YouTube. I mean, there's a lady who does a dildo review show.
I think Trisha Paytas does shows off different kind of dildos on her Patreon.
I thought she was a guy now, though.
I think she's still a chick because she still like puts out nudes on her Instagram. I'm like, and she's not even like remotely like deboobing herself and like trying to have like a surgery or something like that. I think she, I honestly, in my opinion, I think Trisha Paytas was just using that to get views. I think she likes a lot of drama and. You know, I think she just did that for views.
She is a sick person, but I like it. Look at that.
But she's hot. She is hot.
Speaking of
me,
hot.
Me doing flutter kicks. Oh, yes. Oh. I should have aimed that a little bit lower to show what I was doing. But I just like, you know, but then I thought, and I looked at it and everybody was like, yummy. What the heck are you doing, Tommy?
You look like Drew right there. Going, yummy.
Oh, God.
Oh, wait a minute. Can we get that? Can we get a shot of Drew saying yummy and then Tommy, like, right next to him? Like, with, oh, my God. Wait a minute. Hold on a second. Let's get...
Joe, you're twisted sometimes.
Oh, I mean, you guys are...
You got fucking hair in my mouth, dude.
Oh. Oh, you guys are
sick.
Well,
it's tasty.
Watch this. Oh, man. What kind of music was I playing to open up monetize this?
You're damn right you say yeah to that.
All right, let me see here. We get that right there.
Oh, my God. Oh, stop.
You know, Joe, sometimes I find myself singing the songs that you play on your show, like, randomly.
Oh, really? Yeah. Well, I mean, I don't blame you. Some of these are catchy.
Like, for instance, oh, in your butthole.
Yeah, I love that. Well, not only do I love that song, but also it means that somebody donated more than $200. So that's definitely a song that I love to hear. Let's see here. Let's see here if we can get this. Oh, look at this. Look at how his head just pops up. Oh, yeah, look at that. Look at Tommy just taking it.
Oh, come on, Joe.
You're just taking it right there. And now watch this. Look at Drew. He's just... Oh, that's good. Look at him just mowing down. Look at this. Oh, look at that.
It just looks like Drew is licking my arm. Yummy. It doesn't even look like he's licking my... It doesn't even look like... What the fuck?
Yummy.
Oh, my good God. Oh, good God. That noise he makes after. Oh, this just in. We have another. I can't believe this. I have a voicemail from Awandi. Ladies and gentlemen, Awandi is live in Dubai right now. And we are trying to figure out what Awandi has to say live in Dubai right now. Dubai, Abu Dhabi. Here it is. Awandi.
America, go to hell. I hope Jesus Christ dies in your cross again when he comes back. Allahu Akbar, you kusum.
Oh, God, that's horrible, Awandi. God damn, is he angry tonight. Yeah, but this is very strange what's going on. Yeah, Tommy, anything else you wanted to say? I know you probably want to run at this point, but I'm glad you called, man. I appreciate that, and it's good to hear from you tonight.
Oh, folks, so put one in the chat when you want me and Joe to do honestly.
Hell yeah. It's coming. This week. To Patreon.
Hopefully I'm available because Hamza's birthday is this Saturday.
Happy birthday, Hamza. You got the name of a terrorist. Happy birthday, Hamza. Probably related to Bin Laden.
No, he's not. Hamza's from Philadelphia.
Why did they name him Hamza then?
I don't know. Like he
it's a Middle Eastern name.
A sacred man gave Hamza his name.
Really? A sacred man? Sacred Muslim? Yes.
They apparently, I can't remember what it was. It was just some really positive dude gave Hamza his name. Apparently, Hamza, the name means lion.
Well, it is a popular name. I actually grew up with a Hamza five houses away. There was a guy from, I don't know if he was from Iraq or if he where he was from exactly. Maybe Lebanon, I forget. But his name was Hamza. He was my age. He went to school with me. And he was right up the street.
Have you ever watched The Love Guru?
No.
Okay, and the show, no, not The Love Guru. It was Don't Mess with the Zohan.
Oh, yeah, yeah. I didn't see. I remember when it was out, but I didn't see it because it looked so ridiculous. I couldn't even watch it. Was it funny?
It kind of was. There's a scene in the movie where they're dialing a phone number, like, I guess, and they're like, Hamza, Hamza, sete, Hamza, sete, Hamza, 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 sete. And they're dialing a number, but they're saying it in their language. And like, Hamza, Hamza, sete. Hamza, Hamza, sete. Sete, 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 sete. Hamza, Hamza, sete.
All right.
You can look it up. It's a clip from that movie. It's funny. I joke with Hamza all the time about it.
Well, there's something really weird that this guy Kevin tweeted out. This is very strange. This is very strange, and I don't know. Nobody is saying anything about this being fake, but this is very strange. Somebody's calling it ball lightning. Apparently, it's something that can happen. Something called ball lightning.
Ooh.
But no, it's not like your balls, so don't worry. By the way, the Iranians... I mean, like, I don't want to joke about this because I appreciate that they didn't kill our American troops because they could have. They didn't. Although, you know, whatever. But you know, they really didn't take out any U.S. troops, but they did take out a plane of 180 people, allegedly, accidentally. Looks like Iran might have shot this plane down by accident. So that is very strange. But and there's also been double earthquakes in Iran as well now. So there's a lot of weird shit going on tonight, which we don't have the answers for 100%. But yeah, this guy just tweeted this out, and this is so bizarre. What in the world is this? Look at this. Look at that.
Oh my gosh. That's insane. Oh my gosh. The Terminator's coming.
I mean, is this fake? I mean, this has to be a fake video, right? Yeah, everybody was saying that. The Terminator's coming.
No, no, no. No, 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 no.
A lot of people nobody is saying... Nobody's saying that it's fake or anything, but I mean, it looks... I mean, that's hard to believe that that really happened. You know, but people are saying it does. So... Somebody tweeted something, but it's from a suspended account. What the hell is this? Somebody tweeted me something. I'm trying to read the tweet, and it says it's from a suspended account.
You know, Joe, you know how everybody says, subscribe to PewDiePie. Subscribe to PewDiePie, you know?
People want you to subscribe to PewDiePie?
Well, people always say that. I hear people always saying that in videos. Like, but I think... What I'm going to start doing now is going to be like, oh, subscribe to David Dobrik. Like, you know, like make him the king of YouTube.
You always bring up this David Dobrik guy, and I don't even know who the fuck he is, really.
He's an ex-Viner. When Vine basically...
Oh, you know, fuck you then. Fuck him. I hate Viners.
Why do you hate Viners?
Because they're fucking idiots. They're from Vine. They should go back. They're fucking... Their shit died.
Well, you know, I think that, you know, I hate Logan Paul and Jake Paul. They're Viners, but they're scumbags.
Yeah, fuck Viners. We killed them. They're all done. Those Viners are dead. Dead and buried.
Well, Vine turned into TikTok. Well, actually, TikTok was Musical.ly, and then TikTok, and then some company in Japan bought Musical.ly, and then... Turned it into
wasn't Vine? Vine was out way before any of that, wasn't it?
Yeah, Vine was out then, and then Vine went under, and then Musical.ly popped up, and then TikTok bought. A couple years later, TikTok bought Musical.ly and turned into TikTok.
And now the Asians run the soundtrack of your lives, right, Tommy?
I don't know.
What? I don't know. Well, anyway, get the hell out of here. Go to bed. All right, thanks, man, for stopping by. I love you, Tommy.
Yeah, have a good night, Joe.
All right, man. I'll talk to you later.
Talk to you later.
See you, Tom. Thank you to Tommy for giving a call. Now I'm going to close my Skype. Bump, bump, bump. Throw down, motherfuckers!
Here we go. I'm about to get it, man. Here we go. About to get it, man.
Here we go.
Here we go, here we go. Oh, no!
Oh, no.
Iran said they accidentally shot it down. Basically said they didn't deactivate the air defense systems after the missile strikes.
Jesus Christ, man. Now 180 people are dead for all because of nothing. I mean, listen, I hate to go all fucking... tree hugger on everybody here, but 180 people are dead all over a prick waving dick fight. Sucks. So dumb.
My name is Kane and I'm donating.
Kane. What's up, Joe? When you have a second, Joe, check out the tweet I sent you. It looks like some strange Terminator shit. No joke.
Oh, what up, JD Venom? I actually just played that. That's good. That's funny timing. Dude, that did. Everybody was saying that. It looked like the Terminator in the comments. I thought that was funny. Yeah, 100-something families are ruined all because Iran's retarded when it comes to the defense. And, I mean, it's funny. It's not funny, but it's funny that Iran actually looks weird. You know what I mean? Like, they missed their shots, and then they hit a plane.
Cocksucker, suck the cock. I'm allowed to talk forever. I got a fucking dick. I'm not allowed to talk as long as everybody else. Fuck you, fucking cocksucker. Suck your own dick tonight.
Jesus. I love my wife.
Hell of a way to start the new decade with us going to war with Iran. Problem is, this shit will become just like Ira all over again. Just because our military dwarfs everybody else won't mean shit if Russia and China get involved.
Yep.
What a shit show, Joe.
I agree. The Soundwave 92, thank you for the $11. I love Leah's squished face right there. Yeah, dude, can you imagine if it really went down with, like, World War III? Like, we could only handle Russia, right? Russia has, like, the advanced technology. But we have more. I don't know if we have more of it. We would be in, we would have our hands full with Russia alone. There's no way we could take on China and Russia. China has the biggest military in the world, and Russia has the one of the most sophisticated ones, I feel like. So, yeah, that would not be good. That would not be good, because who the fuck is going to fight with us? Who's as... You know what I mean? The Japanese and Germans, like, nobody wants to fight right now. They wouldn't want to fucking fight. And we'd be facing, like, Iran, fucking Russia, China. We'd be fucking crazy. It'd be nuts. But yeah, that was, that's crazy, man. Two earthquakes. In Iran, a plane shot down, all coming just after their response by, look like, basically it looks like purposely missing the target of the military bases for the U.S. Like, they targeted one base that was empty. They targeted another base on the side where it was empty as well. And then the other ones, like, it looks like they didn't even really get that too. They got pretty close, but not close enough. In fact, they might have killed an Iraqi or two by accident. So all signs point to, like, you know, this is the classic, like, you know, you purposely shoot a warning shot past somebody type of deal. Yeah, I don't know, man. It would be crazy. Our air and naval superiority are unmatched, Hector Gutierrez says. Hey, it might be. Yeah, it's true. Patrick Carnes goes, yes, we could, Joe. We have our weapons in mass numbers. China has lots of people. We have radiation for them for dinners. What the fuck? Oh, man. 1001 of Clips says, I hope all Americans that made those World War III memes know that they're at fault, too, because this shit ain't a joke to Iran. We have Rambo and Arnold and Liam Neeson. We're good. I'm not in favor of any type of war. I mean, it's kind of funny we're all talking about it, but I just don't like it, man. I think that everybody... I'm too much of a hippie, bro. I'll tell you guys straight up. You know that I'm mostly in the middle here with things, but I don't like war at all. I don't like it. We need to work together and shit. We don't need to be fucking blowing each other up. It's fucking stupid. And it's stupid. If you think it's not stupid, then you might be a mongoloid. If you think war is good or war is necessary or we need to whatever, probably you're a mongoloid. You know what I mean? It's like, yeah, when somebody attacks you or, like, really attacks you or really threatens you, really does something, you know, you should fight back if you have to. You should fight back if you need to. I'm not saying you shouldn't do that, but sometimes, you know, It'd be better not to have war. It'd be fucking pretty stupid to have it. But let's go to Drew's comments earlier, because this is fucking hilarious to me. Because Drew gets all lit up by this guy in the chat.
Offense. Moron. Everything. Iranian SC in the chat. Let's see. Horizon City. The USA is very self-sufficient in petroleum products now, thanks to fracking. Well, yeah. I've experienced it in a week or two while I was in Wichita from some of the fracking down in Oklahoma. So, yeah. We've got plenty of petroleum to get us by if we wanted to really hit them where it hurt. Casey is raw. I need to put my video games and porn collection in safekeeping. What's up, Racine City? Mm. Yeah, I'm actually just about ready to wrap this up. We were just having a nice little powwow about...
Drew's audio is all fucked because this hotel room's Wi-Fi sucks.
...about what's going on in the Middle East, specifically in Iraq and with Iran and everything. Iranian... FM? What does FM stand for? Can someone let me know in the chat? I don't know FM. Zarif.
Fuck mother.
Says, Iran took and concluded proportionate measures in self-defense tonight. We do not seek escalation or war, but will defend ourselves against any aggression.
And now, so his statement is basically what Iran said. It's a guy from Iran who is saying... You know, yeah, we don't want to escalate this, but we're going to defend ourselves. And, you know, I agree with him. I agree with him. I understand. I think that general guy was doing fucked up shit, it looks like. And he should have been an enemy to us. It was very bad what he was doing. So, yeah, we killed him. You know, do you expect Iran to just not do anything? You know, they've got to do something. And so they did... They did what they did, which was basically, like, we went into their fucking restaurant and shot their chef. And then they ran down the street and threw a rock through our window. You know what I mean? That's what they did. Now, I know that, so, like, you know, I think that, yeah, I mean, I don't know. Like, I think that I understand what they did. I understand why Iran attacked us back. They didn't kill anybody, it looks like. But they did something. It's like when Trump did that. Remember when Trump did that months ago, a year ago or whatever? He launched all those, like, old shitty missiles we had just to send a little, like, hey, we're here, you know, just so you know, but we're not. You know, it was like that warning shot, but we didn't really kill anybody or anything. It's sort of like that. So I can understand from the Iranian perspective that they feel like they're defending themselves. I get that. I get what they're saying. You know, I do. But Drew, this is great. Drew went from so calm and he loses it. Look at Drew is calm.
Yeah, I'm actually just about ready to wrap this up. We were just having a nice little powwow about what's going on in the Middle East, specifically in Iraq.
Zipirito, who is that?
Everything. Iranian.
Zipirito, thanks for subbing to the channel.
What does FM stand for? Can someone let me know in the chat? I don't know FM.
Fuck males.
Zarif says, Iran took and concluded proportionate measures in self-defense tonight. We do not seek escalation or war, but will defend ourselves against any aggression. Self-defense. What are you self-defending from? We did something 4 days ago that was in response to something you did. There was nothing in self-defense. Self-defense is if we sent missiles to you and you shot the missiles down. That's defense. What you did tonight was offense. Morons. Fucking idiot. Go fuck yourself. Jonathan Brown, Iran can't stand a month against
what you. A miserable cunt Drew is. You are a miserable cunt, Drew. You had an Iranian in your chat who was just saying, like, we feel like, you know, we're defending ourselves because of what's gone on, and you just fucking snapped on this guy. You could have been a diplomat and said, like, I can understand that, man, nobody wants, but no, Drew, you savage fuck. You savage son of a bitch. You went at this poor Iranian who was just trying to state that he believes it was self-defense in what they did there. And then you called him a faggot. So now he's like, you're right, Americans are crazy. I went in there and just stated I think it's a defense. And then this guy called me like all this shit.
Everything. Iranian FM. What does FM stand for? Can someone let me know in the chat? I don't know FM. Zarif says,
Zarif.
Iran took and concluded proportionate measures in self-defense tonight. We do not seek escalation or war, but will defend ourselves against any aggression. Self-defense? What are you self-defending from? We did something 4 days ago that was in response to something you did. There was nothing in self-defense. Self-defense is if we sent missiles to you and you shot the missiles down. That's defense.
Now, at this point, I'm fine with Drew. I'm fine with Drew at this point. He's just responding to this guy, but he's getting a little more animated and angry. But he's just responding to this guy. This guy just said his beliefs, you know? So Drew's responding to him, which is fine.
What you did tonight was offense, morons. Fucking idiot. Go fuck yourself.
Go fuck yourself, Drew. What is wrong with you? See, that's my problem right there. You were fine up until that. He was fine up until he said, fuck you, like, and all this shit. Like, Jesus, man. The guy didn't come in here like, we were just defending ourselves against you American scumbags. You cocksucking American scumbags. We were just defending ourselves, you fucks. You know, he didn't come in and say that. He just came in and said, hey, we were defending ourselves, you know, and he posted the thing that they said, which was like, you know, we don't want to go to war, but we'll defend ourselves. And that's all he said. He didn't say, hey, fuck you, America, like, and what the fuck are you doing, or like, hey, blah, blah. He was just nicely saying, like, what the Iranian government said, and he's Iranian himself and from Iran, and so, and you decide that you're just going to call him a fuckhead or whatever, and like, and get angry at him. Like, what the hell, Drew? You had a chance to make him go, oh, Americans are nice too. But no, you went all full red coat, or not red coat, but full red state fucking red-blooded conservative psycho gun nut on this motherfucker who was just coming in here to fucking explain that they were on the defense. You can disagree with him. You can say, you know what, Iranian guy, I disagree with you, bro. What you did is offense. What they did is offense. And here's why. You know, but hey, man, I hope that for our sakes, you know, this dies down now. But no, you just went fucking crazy on him. You're a cocksucker, Drew. You're a piece of shit, Drew. There's a difference between being a pussy And a bully, you know? There is a difference between being a pussy and a bully, you know? But, Drew, you were a bully, man. Drew, you really, the further away people get from you, the more, like, you weren't even drinking here. Because if, you know, you're lucky you weren't drinking, or you would have ended up on this Iranian's YouTube channel apologizing to him. I'll tell you that. But, hey.
Yummy. Yummy.
You know, my wife calls me a Trump supporter every day. She's like, you scumbag Trump supporter. And then today on Twitter, I was like, you know, Trump's going to not get reelected if he keeps this up. I think Trump has a clear shot to the White House. I think if Trump doesn't get us in a war or doesn't get into a war or doesn't get into a war, I think he's got a fucking clear shot into the White House for term number two. Trump is going to be president a second time because these Democrats on the left are like retarded. Like, there's no way. But if he gets us, if we get into a war, I don't think he'll be reelected. I think he's like, this was almost too much today. I think a lot of people who are on the middle on Trump are jumping back to the left side. So he's got to really not do this because this was the big fight we all had. Remember the big fight we all had? Like, Hillary will get us to war. No, Trump will get us in war. Like, that was the big thing that both sides were saying about each other. Like, Hillary's going to get us in war. And I believe that, too, because the generals were already setting up for it from Obama and from the left. And so we really believed that Hillary would take us to war. So that was scary. But then a lot of people said Trump will take us to war because he doesn't know what the fuck he's doing or whatever. And we were like, no, no, no. Like, Hillary's crazy. Why would Trump do that? And so, you know, and I know that it may not be his fault. It may not even be Trump's fault. Trump may just have to do what he has to do. But if he takes us to war, I'm telling you, that big middle that he has on his side is going to jump over really quick to that other side. And you see the fucking nuts over there on the left side right now, because you want one of them becoming president? That could be a whole lot of fun. But, yeah, I don't think it's quite wild. Brazil, no war. What up, Spirito? Spirito? Is that how you're saying it? Hola, Spirito. Brazil is a shithole, says Tiki of Doom. Jesus. Iran is fucking with them on purpose. Yeah, it feels like like people are testing Trump to see what he'll do. I mean, does this feel like a test to anybody else? Because to me, it does. This feels like a test. It almost feels like maybe... I didn't say Trump started it. I don't know who's saying Trump started it. I don't believe Trump started it. Trump got intel on somebody who's been a fucking murderer. You know, there's a lot of Iranians who hate that general, too, because he's been a scumbag to them. But, I don't know, like... Can you imagine? Maybe it's like Putin and everybody, or even the Clintons or somebody, and they're like, hey, you know, let's see if we can get Trump to flip the fuck out or whatever. It almost feels like bait. This almost felt like one big test or one big baiting. Like the murder of this guy was, like, they over-exaggerated the stuff to Trump, made sure he did something, and now this is going on. It feels like one big, like, weird bait job. Doesn't this feel fucking weird to anybody else? Feels weird to me. But yeah, there's going to be no war. There's no World War III. Everybody was like, World War III? You know, all the young kids who didn't get to see 9/11 and didn't get to see all these other things, and kids that didn't get to see wars. You know what I mean? Like, what is it, 2020 now? So yeah, we've been in Iraq throughout their lifetime, but they don't really see it or even know about it. They just kind of hear that we're there, but they don't know. You know what I mean? So all these people that didn't get to see all the fun in the sand, you know, they're all the ones that are like, oh my God, World War III, we're dead. Oh my God, it's crazy. Or told you it would happen. Told you this is going to go down. Like all these fucking idiots. It's like, dude, relax. Relax. The Iranians are bluffing because they don't want to fight. And we don't really want to fight either, but Trump's a badass, if that makes any sense. Trump's a badass, but he doesn't really want to fight, I don't think, anymore. I think this will be the end of it. You know what I mean? And unfortunately, a plane full of 180 people are dead now because... all because of nothing. You know what I mean? All because of nothing. There's a whole plane of people dead right now. Well, because Iran is like retarded with their defense system, but also because, you know, we just decided to wave our dicks around. You know? Well, let's wave our dicks around. Now 180 people are dead in a plane. It's fucking stupid. But yeah, it's definitely blown up. That's true, a shady unit in the chat. It's true that, when the stuff happened on the left, you didn't really hear about it as much. But this is, it's wild. Trump never thought that his bases would be attacked by Iran, says Animal Watching Magazine. Really? Did he not think that? I think he thought that. I think he thought that could happen. I mean, they didn't really attack the bases either. I mean, they did, but they didn't. You know what I mean? Iran purposely missed, I think. But maybe they didn't, because they just hit a plane and killed a bunch of people on a plane by accident. So who the hell knows what they meant to do or didn't mean to do.
You want me to get Ryback? You want me to do it? Finish it.
It's your fault that we accidentally killed 180 people. Truth Locke, what up, Truth? Truth, are you in Irania? Are you an Iranian? Why are you saying it's your fault? Are you in Iran? I mean, I don't think it's anyone's fault. It's everyone's fault. It's the general that was doing this stuff. The embassy attack. The United States embassy was attacked. I mean, does nobody remember that the embassy was attacked first? That's what happened. Does anybody remember that? The fucking United States embassy was attacked. And part of the reason why it was attacked is because this general guy was going over to Iraq and helping militias attack us. So Trump said, well, fuck you. This is like Pearl Harbor. This is like Pearl Harbor. The United States was like, we're not in the war. We're not in the war, guys. We're not in the war. But then we gave guns and ammo and pilots and planes to England and essentially helped them. And Japan is like, what the fuck? You say you're not in the war, but you're helping our enemy. So we're going to fucking attack you now. That's what we did to this guy. Yeah, Iran and America, we don't want to really have a beef right now and do anything. But you know what? This guy's going over and meeting with their militias, and now our embassy's under attack. Well, fuck it. We're killing this guy. He's killed a ton of our soldiers, and we've done nothing. Well, now we're going to do something. And then they say, oh, well, now we're going to do something. And, you know what I mean? And so now, and then they blew up a plane. And it's all over just dumb shit. If Salami Head didn't fucking go to these militias, then none of this would have happened. And then if we didn't retaliate in a strong way and kill them, and then if they didn't retaliate against us and then fuck up their defense weapon, it's just a bunch of escalating dumb shit. You know what I mean? The bottom line is humans are assholes. Humans are scumbag fucks. You know what I mean? Humans. Everybody's just escalating shit. But, you know what I mean? But once it got a little real, finally everybody went, oh, this is dumb. Let's not do this. You know? But there's a plane of 180 people that are dead for just no reason. And that's the worst thing about all this right now. That's the terrible thing right now. I don't care about all this other stuff. You know, it's obviously over. Hello from France. What up? Zayad's 216, how you doing, man? Hey, dude, have you ever seen that guy in France, the black guy who does those hilarious videos on the train where he just scares the shit out of people? Have you seen that guy? We played him a couple months ago on the show, way back, 8 months ago. Bonjour. It was crazy. I can't remember his name right now. Damn it, I can't remember his name. I'm trying to look him up to remember who it is. Man, I can't find him. He's so funny, though. He does. I mean, he's kind of an asshole, too. He just scares the shit out of people in
Shut up and bend over.
On trains.
Finish.
It's really funny, though.
Oh my God, don't finish it. Please don't finish it.
What's up, everybody?
Finish it. Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. Oh, yeah, yeah. Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. Here he is.
Glad you can see that World War III ain't happening because of this. Still sucks that 180 people are fucking dead because of a dick measuring contest. Just goes to show you that the good people are always the ones who suffer the most. Folded hands, prayers to those passengers.
Wow, that is crazy. Soundwave 92, man. Thanks for the 950. I mean, dude, I'm sorry. I'm actually angry about that. And, Shabazz Buda. Thanks for subbing to the channel. I'm sorry if I messed up your name. And dude... They were threatening, Iran was threatening our friends in fucking Dubai. they're threatening to kill Awandi, guys. When I saw that, I was like, oh my God, Awandi was getting fucking emergency notifications on his phone.
A little bit of the bubbly.
That's in it. Abu Dhabi.
Bubbly? Look at this stuff. Oh, a little bit of the bubbly.
That's it.
If Saddam Hussein was still alive, Iran would be shitting themselves. Ryback versus Ziegler on Twitter will start World War III.
That'd be great. Speaking of Awandi, thank you, Awandi, for that donation. It still blows my mind that me and Awandi can send each other voice messages through text instantly, fucking joking around on Facebook Messenger while he's in Dubai. and I'm in America, and you know, I just feel bad for those people who died in that plane, man. 180 people. I feel bad for the families and everybody, and just it's so fucking horrible that just died for no reason because they were on a plane in the wrong place at the wrong time. It's fucking sad. That's what's making me upset right now. You know, kids on the plane, families, just 108, maybe 100-something families affected instantly just now. But here's some more gold from Awandi from Dubai. For the people that are just getting here, I told Awandi to send voice messages to Justin Bailey in Arabic and, like, acting crazy. I told him to act like he hates America now and then he's angry that Iran might blow up his country all because America assassinated this guy and all these things. So I told Awandi to, because Awandi actually likes Trump and stuff, but I told Awandi, I was like, tell fucking Bailey you're angry at him and all this stuff. So Awandi sends Bailey all these fucking messages. Listen to this.
America, go to hell. I hope Jesus Christ dies in your cross again when he comes back. Allah Akbar, you kassum. What the fuck is wrong with your country, you fucking faggot?
It's crazy what's going on. It just makes me mad.
Casey is raw. What up, Casey? Thank you for the $2, Casey. Yeah, it is crazy, man. I mean, I think it's good that everybody's come to... I think everybody's stopped. I don't think it's going to get any worse now. I think we've seen the end of this. I think nobody wants to go any further, I believe. That's what it seems like. So I'll be happy with that. My hippie ass will be happy with that.
And fuck Trump. Shut the fuck up. I'm trying to speak here. You go attack Dubai because you attack Iran? Huh?
Iran.
Iran. Attack Iran because you want to go to war. They attacked you, your embassy. Now you're going to attack. Now Iran is threatening. Now Iran threatening us embassy. They want to attack Dubai and Abu Dhabi. Fuck you and your Trump and American. Fuck you, American! I'll shoot your stomach, Ibn al-Kahba! I'll shoot your stomach! I'll fuck you, soldier! La la la!
Fuck you, soldier!
La 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 la!
Ha la la la! Fucking, dude, Awandi even threw that in there. That is fucking hilarious. Meanwhile, this guy's country is under threat from Iran that they're gonna blow fucking Dubai up. All the way from Dubai, there was Awandi's voice messages that we sent to Bailey. But we didn't tell Bailey that it was a joke. So we were hoping that Bailey would be like, what the fuck? And apparently Bailey has blocked Awandi on Facebook. So we don't know if Bailey knows it was a joke.
America, go to hell. I hope Jesus Christ dies in your cross again. أمك وقص أم ترامب وقص أم أهلك الأمريكا Fuck you America Fuck you America's dick my suck my dick
I think Awandi was having trouble if he wanted to speak English or Arabic there or what he wanted to say so it like mixed in with my dick oh my god holy shit oh man Awandi is hilarious Awandi loves America, though, so. Oh, man. Oh, JB did not block you? Okay, good. I thought it was a joke. God damn. I'm getting a phone call. Hey, 412's on the phone. Hello.
Hey, is this Joe Cronin?
This is Joe Cronin. Who is this?
Hey, I'm calling about that Awandi.
Yeah, from Dubai, yeah.
Yeah, hey, Wandy, hey, listen, motherfucker, you brown sheep fucking son of a bitch. We're coming for you, buddy. We're coming for you. This is a defensive move, as Drew would say. You want to attack America? We're coming for you, hey, Wandy.
Oh, my God. Well, C-U-M-M, right?
What's that?
C-U-M. Like, we're coming for
listen
him.
Listen to me. Listen to me, Joe Cronin. I'm telling you right now. We're going to come get those dirty brown motherfuckers, and we're going to take them, we're going to slit their fucking throats,
and we're going to
kill their children, okay?
Oh, no, my God. Come on, man. Oh, my God. Jesus.
Yummy.
Oh, man. It was good until the kid thing was said. Jesus. Jesus Christ, man. Oh, my God. Oh. Nobody wants kids hurt.
I'm a fucking idiot. Yummy. Yummy.
Oh, my God. Jesus Christ. 412, thanks for the call, though. Holy Christ. He said, come at me, bro. Denise in the chat said, Awandi is the JCS Iron Sheik. Yes. I ship out for boot camp the 27th at Paris Island. Wow. Captain Fabian, thank you for your service. What's up, chat? I'm going to stare at the chat now, or we'll just talk to you guys about the chat. Check out the video I sent you on Twitter, Jason Bird. Okay, man. Did you send me another one of a electronic force field floating through the sky? Breaking video shows Ukrainian passenger plane carrying 180 people that crashed near Tehran. There are no indications of any survivors. Well, no shit. Oh, my God, man. That's nuts. Oh, God, that's just awful. George Carlin knew exactly what he was talking about. Oh, man, that's just terrible to watch that. That's fucking horrible. I don't like that. Can somebody translate the writing in the chat? I can't quite see what that... Let me see. Hold on a minute. The missiles... Oh, wait. This is in Spanish. What am I doing? Hold on a minute. Iran missile attack on U.S. base. What Erdogan and... have said in this context details. Any gaming studio, what Erdogan and Mahathir have said in this context, general chat language lounge? What, that doesn't make any sense, really. It's not really, I don't know what you're saying, any game studio. It's kind of weird. I don't think we can really make that out. I don't know what language. Bangla? I don't know. I can't really make out that language. Yeah, I can't see. Can't quite make it out. Let me see here. Let me try to make it out again. 1 second. Said Oka Boka, Oka Boka, Oka Boka. It's like I love somebody or love you or something. I don't know. Oka Boka. I don't fucking know how to say it. It sounds like I'm saying I like boogers. But anyway, I don't know what you said. But yeah, it looks like it's over with. Selective Service System, the Tamil Nadu language. Oh, okay. Nice. Selective Service System. Thank you. Any game studio is a Russian spy. Maybe. You know what? One of the things that I do love, man, about the world, though, is how we do all get along. You know what I mean? How we all get along together many times. You know, how we can talk to people from France, from Russia, Iran, you know, Dubai, the Middle East, Saudi Arabia, China. Well, not China. China's pretty much. We never get really anybody listening from China because they're suppressed. But Japan, you know, just the idea that we hear from all people all over the world. Canada, Mexico, Brazil earlier, you know, Africa. It's really cool. That's the cool thing about technology now is we've always been able to chat, you know, once the internet came out. But now we're really able to sort of engage, you know, with people. So 484 is on the phone. Hello.
Hello. This is the Iron Sheik. I have a question about Iran.
Yes.
Soleimani, you are faggot.
That's not a question. That's a statement. Come on.
Yummy.
That's a statement, man. Hey, let's take a minute to take a little bit off of this war talk and go into when Tommy NC the other day farted in his workout video. Take a listen to this. I think people from all over the world, no matter where you're from, can enjoy a good passing of gas.
Guys, another day in the books. And I want to wish everybody a happy new year. And I hope everybody... Oh, cleaning up my system there. Shout out to the girdles. That's a letter to turd, guys.
Oh, man. That's certainly... The real Iron Sheik is saying he's in the chat right now, but I don't know. I'm not really sure if that's really him. But I agree. War sucks. Fuck war. I agree. No war. Fuck war. Nobody wants war. No war! Nobody wants war. We all want to fuck people. That's what we want to do. We all want to have sex with women. That's what we all want to do. And the women want to have sex with the men. And we all want to raise kids and eat some food and have a good time and play with our fucking cellular devices and potentially, hopefully, fight off cancer someday. But nobody wants war, and it's horrible that plane got shut down, man. That is just terrible. I do have to tell you guys also that earlier today I put up Morning Madness episode 199. We are one episode away from 200 episodes on Patreon. So if you guys did not hear my Morning Madness episode 199, go give that a listen. Go check it out. Episode 199 of Morning Madness. It is up. You can download it on Patreon, and I would really love it if you become patrons. Over 2,000 posts become available to you when you become a patron of $5. Even 1,000 when you're less, but... Morning Madness 199 is up right now. If you didn't hear it, you can download it to your phone. All that shit. Play it. Download it. Whatever. And, you know, I'm just checking on the update about this shit that's going down. Trump saying all is well or whatever tells me that they're done too, I think. So. Everything does seem to be kind of over. Shocked Iraqi. No, that's a fake story. I'm not going to read that. That's not real. Yeah, I don't see any other news that's really... I don't see any other important news. So I don't think there's anything else really to get to as far as what's going on. So I think we're good. Thank you to the chat. Thank you to everybody who's been listening all night. If you're new to the channel here on Corrupted Nation, I hope you guys subscribe down below. What do you guys think? Is this the end? Is this the calm before the storm? Is there more coming? Is it over? Or will there be other things? What do you think about the planes being shot down here, or the plane being shot down? I'm sorry, there's only one. What do you think about all this shit, man? What do you guys think? Leave it in the chat down below afterwards. I'll read it afterwards. So, I will check that out. Let me know what you think. And I hope everybody has a good night, man. And I'm just, feel fucking terrible for these, for the, plane that was shot down, man. That's the worst. But, see you guys tomorrow for AEW review over on the Joe Cronin Show. The AEW review will be live after AEW. And then Thursday night, we'll have Out of Nowhere. And then, of course, Friday night, right back here on this channel from Monetize This. And then Saturday, Corrupted Podcast. If you missed Corrupted Podcast last Saturday, it's one of my favorite episodes all time, top 15 episodes. So if you have not heard Corrupted from last Saturday, get over to Patreon to listen to that as well. Download it, whatever. I thought it was a top 15 episode, in my opinion. A lot of other people were saying they enjoyed it, so it seems like it was a good episode. Check that out if you have not heard it yet. I think you'll enjoy it as a podcast. Me, Leah, D-Moon, and Justin Bailey, I had a lot of fun. Thank you guys in the chat. Thank you everybody who donated tonight for supporting Throwdown here on Tuesday nights, starting at 10 p.m. Eastern Time U.S. And I hope you guys leave some comments below later on. We'll take a look at it. And if you can, leave a like below if you like the video. If you like the shit I was doing here, give me a like, man. We want war between PUBG and CODEM gamers. COD gamers? Okay. Yeah, well, hey, let's go, man. Let's do it. Tell me what side you're on, though, because I want to be on your side. Just let me know what side I should be on. And remember, the brand new Stabbing Westward EP is out right now. We're going to have Chris Hall on the show from Stabbing Westward. First EP, first music in 19 years. Even though Chris Hall did have a band, The Dreaming, the last 19 years, this Stabbing Westward EP, Dead and Gone, is now available on Bandcamp and stabbingwestward.com. And then next week we're going to have, I believe next week, we're going to have Sean Danielson from Smile Empty Soul. He's going to be on the show, and the Sean Danielson solo stuff he does. And we're going to have more guests coming up over the next few months. Non-wrestling guests here on Corrupted, wrestling guests over on the JCS channel. Only got one person lined up over there so far for that, but it will be, we've had like 40 interviews with wrestlers, believe it or not, on Joe Cronin's show. But we've only had about four different band interviews in the past. So we're looking to do a lot more of that, those things, podcasts, interviews, hangouts, whatever you want to call them. So looking forward to that. Smile Empty Soul and Stabbing Westward, both bands that I enjoy. So it's cool to get guys like that on the show. All right. We'll see you guys later. Get wet. We've got an unknown caller. This should be good. Unknown caller, hello. Hello. You are live. Holy Christ, bro. Hello. All right, they're retarded. They are retarded. What the fuck? All right, guys. Good night.
You got-